One of the most anticipated releases of the year caused a huge debate. How short is Day Order 1886? The answer to that is, not short enough. The Order 1886 is about 5 to 6 hours short, curtained, end scene, and sentenced to death before trial. But in the middle of all the anger, we seem to miss what it's all about. Instead of focusing on hours, minutes, and seconds, we should focus on whether those short hours is worth the effort of actually playing the game. And after 7 hours with the Order 1886, my answer is no. It's not about the length of the game, it's about ready at dawn not knowing what to do with it. They are trying to tell us something, but the alternative London in 1886 is just a bunch of knights around the round table, werewolves or half-breeds as they call them, immortality and the Holy Grail. They're trying to make a game, but the battles are painfully generic and it's been made much better by far older games. Red Dead Dawn are really trying to speed up the tempo, but it feels like I'm walking the Green Mile sometimes. At times there's nothing going on the screen and I'm forced to walk, cause sometimes Sir Galahad forgets how to run over big open spaces. And I'm not feeling anything except from being very, very bored. So Red Dead Dawn lacks the edge, and it's surprising considering that the studio has Daxter and God of War on its resume. So in the beginning of the game, in the prison dungeon under the Westminster, that's just a long quick time event scene. Despite many other things, these quick time events makes a point. When I'm trying to escape from the dungeon, I feel like Sir Galahad. I feel the power in his punches, I feel the pain in his wounds. So quick time events can be used in very smart ways. Telltale makes it all the time. Yu Suzuki made it already in Shenmue, so it can be done, but the developers eventually loses it, and the final boss battle, which should be epic, is more or less a copy of yet another QuakeTime event a couple of hours ago. It should be a nerve-wracking battle, but it's just wrecking, so why they made it like that, that's just beyond my mind, I can't wrap around it. But the developers managed to make some great moments in the history. I mean, walking around the Nikola Tesla's lab with all his badass weapons, that is awesome. And it's awesome to infiltrate a retro-futuristic blimp, or it's awesome to walk around the hospital that reeks of death. You really get a feeling for it. The fusion of the elegant Victorian design with things that shouldn't be there is as clever as it is believable. But it takes it a couple of notches too far and goes from fascinating to the absurd. But if you look at the visual aspect of the game, the developers really hit a home run. They hit a grand slam. The order is stunningly beautiful. And I didn't run into a single bug in the entire game, it didn't lag, and for this period in the gaming world that is unusual. Despite everything, The Order is a bold game. The developers are brave, they dare to be different about the aesthetics of the game, but they get lost in the mechanics. There's too many slow moments in the game, and by that I mean really slow. And the frustration I feel when I'm forced to sneak around in the garden and have to kill a whole bunch of guards in stealth mode. I mean, if I make a single mistake, I'm being set back to square one again. And the common battles are painfully generic, as I said earlier. I can say one thing about the developers. They have a good mix of terrible ideas and something that can resemble great things. One great thing is the weapons in the arsenal. One of the guns charges up and shoots lightning, a nudge to Tesla perhaps, through werewolves and other enemies. But my favorite amongst the weapons is without a doubt the gun that releases a gas cloud with R2 and then lights it all up with a spark with a simple push on the R1 button. To be able to release a gas cloud over a bunch of enemies and then follow it up with a spark, it's hard to beat. Other than that, the spark is lacking in this game. For every great moment in the game, there are 9 bad ones. Red Dead Dawn wasn't prepared for a AAA game which the PS4 community relied on for the gaming experience of this spring-winter of 2015. It's a great technical demo with a couple of good ideas, a bunch of bad ones, and a whole lot of things we've seen for the past decade. I just can't get over the feeling of disappointment with this game. It's stunningly beautiful, but it's boring. It's so very boring. So, before you pick it up at the store, make sure it's on discount or you can borrow it from a friend, because full price, it's not worth it. If you like this video, please leave a like, leave a comment, let me know what you think about the game. Are you gonna pick it up? Have you picked it up? How long did you play it for? That's about it. Thanks a lot for watching. My name is Hanks, and I give this game 4 points out of 10. See you next time.